quietly, that means not chit-chatting with their neighbors, not chit-chatting with them. Jimmy, that is not appropriate. Sit down in your seats and work quietly and nicely. Hey, put a bubble in your mouth, in your mouth. Put a bubble in your mouth, in your mouth. I need Hayden doing her work. I need Elizabeth not talking to her neighbors. Put a bubble in your mouth, in your mouth. Yay. All right, second graders. For those of you who are home, today we did the lesson 13 sprint. Okay. Let me get that out for you real quick. You can pause the video. Do as many as you can in 10 minutes. Then you turn it in on Dojo. So pause the video, do as many as you can. Turn in the answers on Dojo. Okay, then, oh, sorry, that's lesson 14. But that'd be fine too. Because that, it, the sprints do not make big, excuse me. We are not chit-chatting with your neighbors, Haiti and Ashlyn. I think you two need to think about your choices and let's try to make a better one. Okay, so lesson 13 sprint, pause the video. Do it, turn it in on Dojo. Troy, let's make better choices. It is not a dance class in here. I wish it were because that would be really fun, but it's totally not. So we don't get to like break dance during class. This is the lesson 13 problem set. You need to be building numbers. Pause it. Build the numbers using place value disks. Turn it in on Dojo. For those of you who need an example of how to do that, this is the number 136. I built that using place value disks. I need to Haiti in her seat and I need Ashlyn in her seat. You two have lost the privilege. When you're dancing around all over the place, you don't get to stand up. Okay? So I put 100, I put 3 10s and I put 6 1s to build the number 136. That's what you guys should be doing. What Danny? Very quickly. What Hayden? Drink, get a drink of water. Sit down, do your work. Okay, I hear lots of noise from the first graders. You guys are being very disruptive. What? Elizabeth, I'm trying to do my lesson. Okay, Jimmy, stop it. This has been the 157th time today. I've asked you to quit disrupting my class. Okay? We're done. Now, no more, first graders. It is not fair to the second graders that I am constantly having to stop and talk to you guys. Goodness gracious. Okay. Oh, those of you at home, I better tired of it too, for goodness sake. All right, we're going to talk about a problem now. Listen very carefully so we can do this together. A second grade class has 23 students. That's a big class, huh? We got 21 first and second graders. A second grade class has 23 students. What's the total number of fingers of all students? What? So listen to that carefully. A second grade class has 23 students. Say, Haiti. What's the total number of fingers of all students? I need Anaya sitting in her seat. Okay, Troy, do you have an idea? What? Really? You guys will only have 10 fingers between all of you? That means in 23, like you have less than half a finger each. Less than half a finger each to have 10 fingers total. So let's think about that. So we've got 23 kids in this class, 23 students. How many fingers does each student have? Each student has how many fingers, Sophia?
I have
they only have one hand? How many fingers does each kid have? Right? Do you have 10 fingers? Unless you're in a horrible accident or your body was just made differently, you have 10 fingers. Some people's bodies are made differently and that's totally okay, right? But we're gonna assume that everybody's body was made the same in this class and each kid has 10 fingers, okay? Some people's bodies are made different and that's totally fine, but we're gonna assume that they have both hands. Okay, so they don't have five, they have 10 fingers, and that their hands are all made the same as ours, okay? Like I say, it's totally different if people's hands aren't. That just makes them extra cool, right? Extra different, extra unique. But in our case, all 23 have hands like ours. They have 10 fingers each. So guess what? I would draw 23 place value discs. 10. 20, 30, or just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Do you think this is a lot faster than trying to draw 10 fingers for each kid? Yeah. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. And if we remember our place value song, which Miss Kennison is so excited about, 10 ones make 10. 10 groups of 10 make 100. So do you think we should maybe find our groups of 100? Yes. Yes, we should. Hold on, Ellie. So let's find our groups of 10 so we can find groups of 100. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 groups of 10 make 100. Let's go. Let's see if we have another group. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 groups of 10 make 100. Okay, do I have 10 left over here? No, 1, 2, 3, I only have 3. Okay, so guess what? I have 100 plus 100 plus 10, 20, 30. 3 groups of 10 would be 30. Okay, so I could do it like that. I like to, and this is my personal preference, line it up in the place values. Because I find that really, really easy to add 0, 3, 1 plus 1 is 2, equals 230. Okay, excuse me, first grade. You guys are being way too loud. You are being very disruptive. Goodness gracious. Stop. Okay, so if you guys notice, you had 23 students. You just added a 0 to that to give us how many fingers. What? Mind blown. Okay, 23 students have 230 fingers. 23 students have 230 fingers. That's a lot of fingers. So, if we have 21 kids in class, how many fingers do we have in class?
210.
Very good. 210. All right. All right. Okay. Ellie, what was your question, sweetheart? What, honey? So, after you do both pages, two pages, right? And you turned it in on Class Dojo, then you get onto Zurn. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate you being responsible and doing your work. Thank you very much. And thank you for waiting patiently. Try not to chit-chat to your neighbors. Danny, do you have your work done? Do you have your work all done? Hey, just get Hayden on the right page, then Hayden needs to do her own work. Hayden needs to do her own work when she's on the right page. Okay, second graders, alive, awake, alert, enthusiastic. Okay, you guys all should have your whiteboards and your markers out. If you don't, get them out quick. Rudy's prepared, Ashlyn's prepared already. Okay, so Sophia, honey, get out your whiteboard and your marker. Quick, 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 quick as a wink. Quick, 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 quick as a wink. I see Jay is ready. I see Troy is ready. I see Samuel's ready. Suhaiti's ready. Rudy's ready. Ashton's ready. We're waiting on Amy and Sophia. Danny, back up. You're in her space. Hayden, you need to be responsible. Amy, we're not playing with those masks. Okay, I need you guys on your whiteboards. I need you to draw a place value chart. Now, we're just going to do ones, tens, and hundreds. Now, I need Valerie to pay very close attention to this. Is it important which way our place values go? Yes. So here's the outline of my board. You guys don't need to draw that. You should already have a board, right? Just draw one line and two lines. Our ones are always, always, always to the right. Ones. And then it always goes tens. And then it always goes hundreds. And then it would go thousands, ten thousands, hundred thousands. Okay. And then millions. 10 million, 100 million. And then billions.
Wow. That's cool.
I can't hear you. And nobody took your marker. It wasn't on the ground. Go look again. Okay. I can't. I don't know what to tell you. Your markers are in your desks. Unless you took them out. Or left them in art class, which. They should be in your bins. They should be in your desk somewhere. Did you have it out this morning? Find it. Okay. On your place value chart, those of you who are ready, pretty much everybody except for Miss Sophia, because she needs to find her, locate her marker. Please write the number 14. Think about where they go in the place values. Hurry up, Amy. Okay, I don't know what number Amy's writing, but it's not 14. I don't know what to tell you, Sophia. Your marker should be in your desk. Although, remember, there was that black marker that did not have a name on it, but you had one with a name on it, didn't you? There was that one that didn't have a name on it that somebody left in art, but you should have one with a name on it. Okay, if you built the number 14, it should look like this. Hold on. It should either look like this with one group of 10 and one, two, three, four ones, or it should look like this, one group of 10 and four ones. Either way, you have the number 14. You do not write it in the hundreds. You certainly don't add extra digits. That would be 114 hundreds. That would be a lot. Okay? When I say 14, it's one group of tens of four ones. Okay? Okay, now. If I wrote 14 ones, right? If I just did 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, could that still be 14? Yes. Sorry, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. There we go. Could that still be 14? Yes, we would just say, look at this. That's a group of 10. I exchange it for a 10 disc. And then we still have our four ones. 1, 10, four ones, 14. Right? 1, 10 and four ones is the unit form. Okay? 10 plus 4 is the expanded form. And then just standard form is 14. Right? Okay, write 12, please. Write the number 12 on your place values. To be specific. Write 12. Those of you at home should be doing it on a whiteboard or a paper if you don't have a whiteboard. All right, Amy, I don't know what you've done. You've appeared to do nothing. Thank you, Jaya. Thank you, Ashlyn. Sophia, come borrow this marker. You should be responsible. There's no reason you should not have this. The only place that marker should be is in your desk, correct? The marker should not even go to art. But some people forgot them in their bins, but they shouldn't even go to art. The markers should be left here. So I'm very frustrated. Come up and borrow this one that hasn't been touched for over 72 hours, so it's safe. Yes, but you guys need to be responsible. Just like Max couldn't find things in his desk today. Your desks are such a mess, you can't find anything in them. Ridiculous. Okay. So I've got a question. Okay. Is 110 and two ones equal to 12 ones? Thumbs up if you think it's true. Thumbs down if you think it's false. That is true, right? We could exchange this to a 10, the one group of 10, right? So that would be true. If you guys did what I asked, you should have gone two ones, one, one, and one group of 10. You built 12, or you built 12 like that. Okay. Amy, you are wasting a lot of time. We are not filling in those circles. We are not doing that. I don't know why you erased all your labels at the top. Like, you're just spending all your time erasing and drawing instead of thinking and doing the work with us, and you're wasting our time. So let's please do our work quickly and carefully. I want you guys to show me the number 140. Show me the number 140. Show me that number using your place value discs on your place value chart. Amy, we're not coloring them in. Come on. Mr. Squatrito, could you please go check on Hayden? All right, did you build this number carefully and correctly? We put 100, we put 4 tens. Did we put any ones?
No.
No, that number right there tells us. So unit form, we would write it like this, 100, 4 tens. Do we have to write 0 ones?
No.
No, we don't. Okay. If we did just tens for this, we would have to do 14 tens, right? We could do 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 110, 120, 130, 140. And then we would say, okay, these all need to be exchanged for 100, right? Okay. Now, do you guys think 14 tens, just like what I drew, is equal to 140 ones? Rudy says yes. Amy says yes. Ashton says yes. Troy says yes. Yes. 14 tens. We'd add that 0. It would be 140. Equals 141. Very good. Very good, boys and girls. We're getting those place values a little bit better. Please show me the number 512. Please show me the number 512. Thank you, Troy. Thank you, JSA. But I can't see any of your work. You know, you haven't shown me a single thing, right? Because you block it with your body, so I can't even see it. So that shows me 512. Ah, it does not look like what? I'll put it over there. Put it back on my desk. There is paper on that bookshelf over there by the books. I do not have time to go hunt up another marker for you. No. Right down there on the bottom of that kind of brown metal bookshelf right over there. This piece of paper. Yep, grab that piece, go use your pencil. You're gonna have to do it there. And then I would highly recommend finding a time today to try to look through that desk and clean it up. Because there's no reason your marker should be gone. Especially because it was labeled with your name. Okay, 512. How many hundreds discs did you use? I don't know what number Amy's writing, but it's wrong. 512. So, Haiti. Right, if you do it with your 100 discs, I should see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many tens did you do, Rudy? 512. Jay, help him out.
3 plus 1. 1.
In the number 12, 512, there is 110. And how many ones, Samuel?
2.
Okay. Now I want to know.
Correct. So
500. 1, 10, 2 ones. Is that equal to?
There's
500 and 12 ones. Is that equal to it? Yes. Right? It's the same number. You just didn't exchange those one yet, the 10 ones for 10 yet. Okay. So make sure. Now, did you guys know that 500s would be, you know, 10 ones make 10. 10 groups of 10 make 100. So 5 groups of 10 would be 500. 1, 10 there. So 50 tens and 2 ones is also equal to 512. What?
Mind blown.
Okay. So if you see something, if you see something like this, 100s, 5 tens, 2 ones.
3 plus 1 is 1.
Is what number?
3 plus 1 is 1.
100, 5 tens, 2 ones. What number is that, Jaya? Ding, 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 Jaya. 152.
Is what?
What if you see the number? 5 tens. I'm sorry, 15 tens, 2 ones. What is that number? Jaya? I mean, Sahady?
152.
152. What? What? What number is 11 tens? What number is 11 tens?
Right.
Ashlyn?
You only add 1 to 3.
Not 200. And 10. 110. Pat yourself on the back if that's what you're going to say. What would 100 and 110 be? What number would that be? Rudy? Not 101, is that a 1 or is that a 10? So 110. What? Okay. 110 and 3 ones. Like, so there's many ways to write the same number, right? 110 and 3 ones. What number would that be? 110 and 3 ones. Samuel? 13. What if I say 13 ones? What number would that be, Samuel? What? 13 ones would be, right? Don't confuse yourself. Okay. It, well, it's not always going to be the same number, but 12 tens and 9 ones. 12 tens and 9 ones. What would that be? Valerie? Oh, you're so close, sweetheart. You're so close. No tomato, but so close. Pay attention. Pay attention. So, Haiti?
129.
Very good. This would be that group of 10. That, you know, 10 tens make 100. 129. Okay, just like if I wrote it 100s, 2 tens, 9 ones, what number would that be? Valerie? No, you can't say 101. How many tens are this? How many tens? You go 10, 20. And how many ones? Nine. Ones. Nine. 129. I like to squish all my letters, my numbers together. Okay. Very good. Very good. Yeah, now I know what time it is because my clock there does not work. But actually, it's about time. So really, really quickly, I just want to say, so if I have the number 200, 200 is made of two groups of 100. 10 tens, or 10 ones make 10. 10 groups of 10 make 100, right? So this would be 10 tens. 10 tens. Okay? 10 tens equal 20 tens. 20 tens is the same thing as 200. What? Mind blown. Okay, so tomorrow you guys will do the lesson 14 sprint and then the lesson 14 problem set. Have a wonderful day.